Hey you guys, it's your girl Moet. So I'm here at the Skrimp Shack in Charlotte. It is on
Central
and East Way. I've never been before, so we're gonna see how this tastes. I'm gonna show y'all the building. Gonna probably eat inside. I'll show y'all some of the menu and we'll get right to it. So yeah, see ya. Just trying to like show where it's at. Okay, so here's my food. I got one of my food partners today, Chris. But listen, so I got collard greens. Macaroni. So, the guy did let us know that it's not baked macaroni. He said it's more like a cream. He compared it to like a Kraft. But I said, you know what, I'm gonna still try it. It is what it is. I got whiting and shrimp. Chris got haddock and shrimp. I've had haddock maybe one time. Oh, you got flounder? Okay, never mind. I stand corrected, he got flounder. So, this is the cocktail sauce, which I don't eat cocktail sauce. I don't care for it. Oh, sugar, almost lost my whiting. And tartar sauce. So yeah, I'm about to put some hot sauce and stuff on it and then let's see how this thing is tasting, y'all. And I got a sweet tea. Okay, so I'm gonna taste one of Chris' fries. So this is how the fry look. It's like a fry. Nice and hot. Let's see. So this is the collard greens.
He said it was hit. So
let's see how I like it. Oh yeah.
Order for Clarence.
That's good. Collard greens are good. It's a softer consistency, so she kind of cooked it down a little bit more, but it's really good. And when I say softer consistency, it's like I don't know how to compare it to something. I'm trying to compare certain parts of it. Macaroni. He did warn me. It's not bad, but
crap.
It's not bad, but it's noodles with cheese. It's not baked macaroni. So. And this is a shrimp. I love the way it's fried. I love the way it's fried. Not too hard, not too soft. And honestly, it doesn't need tartar sauce.
It doesn't. It's really good.
I got whiting.
And it gave you about 5 pieces of whiting. I got a dinner. I didn't get a basket. Fried too hard at all. I don't know, it just fried right.
And it's fantastic.
Everything's good. I'll give it about 7. I haven't tried that yet. I'm gonna give it a 7.
So how's everything?
So
yeah, I'm about to get some more tartar sauce.
I'm going to taste the banana pudding soon.
Everything else all right?
Okay, so I'm going to try the banana pudding. It is homemade. It is made in-house. It looks really good.
Order for down.
They do have nice music here. They play really dope music. So it's a cool atmosphere. We're sitting outside. I don't know why I do this to myself. I sit outside in these restaurants knowing they're going to work. I can't stand sitting outside because the day going to fly. Trying to get some of that cookie because I got the whip. I love whipped cream. It's good banana pudding. I think they, oh hold on, no, here we go. It's good. It ain't my grandma's, but it's good. It is good. So overall, I'm gonna give this spot an 8. And the only reason for that, the macaroni. I personally feel like the macaroni should not be an item on the menu. I feel like it's a kid's menu, macaroni. And it sucks because when you go to Black-owned businesses and you see macaroni, you're expecting baked macaroni and cheese. And that's not what it is. It's not baked macaroni and cheese. So that's the only thing. The macaroni was okay. I mean, it was nothing to rave about. But other than that, the food's really good. The atmosphere is dope. The owners are cool. The owner came, one of the co-owners came in, you know, checking on everybody, making sure they enjoy the food. But yeah, all in all, I would say most definitely come support them. Come check this spot out. And yeah.
Order for that.
See ya.